And Morgan and I have both covered presidential events and have seen firsthand just how tight and intense security protocol is during those events. And if you're wondering how a bullet was able to reach Trump's head tonight, you're not alone.
I spoke with a former Secret Service agent tonight who lives in Minnesota, who says that outdoor open air events like this are the most dangerous.
You're also working at the same time that if something were to happen, what does your incident response look like then?
Mike Olson knows better than most. He was in the Secret Service. He spent years covering these types of campaign events, saying that planning usually begins 3 to 5 days in advance.
Secret Service trains over and over and over ad nauseum from day one all the way through your entire career for these types of scenarios, especially an on-stage rally situation like that.
Olson says that former President Trump had the highest level of security. The Secret Service and law enforcement clear the area hours before the event is supposed to start with security tools, including specially trained canines. Then they require everyone to walk through metal detectors at the entrances. No matter how much precaution is exercised, there's always a risk that something could happen.
Open air events are by far the most, you know, scary events for Secret Service to have to try and protect, because you have to consider all possibilities.
Once everyone was cleared from the event, the Secret Service and local law enforcement sealed off what they call a crime scene. Mike says now the assassination attempt investigation will be led by the FBI, which is standard protocol.